Hello and welcome to Candela. In the previous lecture, we discussed about the cephalic features of Australopithecus. In this lecture, let us discuss the postcranial features of Australopithecus. By all probability, Australopithecus were bipedal. The savanna-like vegetation in which they lived forced them to walk on the ground. Along with these, there are a number of anatomical evidences to show that Australopithecus were bipedal. Let us discuss these anatomical evidences which shows that Australopithecus were bipedal. Foramen magnum of Australopithecus was more centrally placed like human beings. We know that the foramen magnum is the small opening found in the backside of the head through which the brain continues as the spinal cord. During the course of evolution, the foramen magnum descended from the most posterior position to more central position. See, for animals with quadrupedal locomotion, that animals which uses all the four limbs for locomotion, for them to position their head face forward, the foramen magnum generally will be placed more posterior. See, for this, the foramen magnum is positioned more posterior. This side is posterior, this side is anterior. And when the organisms got an erect posture, in the course of evolution, when the hominids got an erect posture, the foramen magnum from the more posterior side, it descended slowly down and now it is more centrally placed for Australopithecus. So the more central position of the foramen magnum of Australopithecus shows that Australopithecus were bipedal. That means they used only two hind limbs for walking and not the four limbs. The forearms were free for Australopithecus. The next aspect, next postcranial aspect of Australopithecus, that is the presence of a curve in the lumbar region of the backbone. This portion, this is called as the lumbar region. For the primitive quadrupedal apes which had a quadrupedal locomotion, vertebral column used to have only a single arch. But when the hominids got an erect posture, this foramen magnum descended down. Along with this, even the single arched vertebral column became a multiple arched. This is a weight bearing modification. We call this as an anticlinal vertebra. You know about fold mountains. Himalayas represents Himalayas or tertiary fold mountains. See, the upstanding portion of the fold mountains are called as is called as an anticline, while the low lying portion is called as a syncline. This is the reason behind the name anticlinal vertebra. Just like this anticline and syncline, the curve, because of the curve, this vertebral column is named as an anticlinal vertebra. For Australopithecus, though these curves are not perfect, still there is a curve in the lumbar region, and hence this suggests that Australopithecus might have developed an erect posture. Torsion angle of the femur bone and the bowl shape of the pelvis. This bone is called as, this bone is the pelvis. For animals with a quadrupedal locomotion, pelvis used to be plate-like. And in the course of evolution, when we got erect posture, the pelvis became bowl-shaped. Even for Australopithecus, the pelvis is bowl-shaped. Then the torsion angle of the femur bone. This is the femur bone, the bone found in our thigh region. That is the femur bone, femurus. So the way in which, see the way, look at the way in which the femur bone gets attached to the pelvis. There is an angle. This bone is not straight like this. Instead, there is an angle at which this bone is attached to the pelvis. This is a weight bearing modification. So if the bone is straight, that entire body weight will come on straight away, fall on the knees. So this is a weight bearing modification. Tarsian angle alpha, the femur bone of the Australopithecus. Linea aspera. Linea aspera is well developed for Australopithecus. This linea aspera is a small groove found in the backside of the femur bone. This is the femur bone. The bone in our thigh region, femur bone. So as the hominids got erect posture, there is a need for the thigh region to have extra muscles for locomotion. So the attachment surfaces originally present was not sufficient to hold the muscles. So in the course of evolution, a small groove developed in the backside of the Australopithecus. You can see here this groove, this one which runs across the bone. This is called as linea aspera. So the presence of linea aspera in the femur bone of Australopithecus suggests that Australopithecus had an erect posture and bipedal locomotion. The next feature is the knees of Australopithecus are straight. See here, after the curves in the vertebral column and the Tarsian angle, the knees were straight. This was meant for the stability. Knees are straight. You can see here, just like human beings, even for Australopithecus, the knee bones are straight. Then now, the bones of the feet shows a number of weight-bearing modification, so that the entire weight will not fall in a single lift. So that the entire weight will not straight away come and fall here. Instead, the body weight will be made to radiate throughout the feet. The most important thing here is the arching of the feet bones. Arching of the feet bones. And you can see number of modifications in the heel and in the ankle. These modifications are not found in the forearms. All the modifications are found only in the hind limbs, which suggests that Australopithecus had an erect posture and a bipedal locomotion. But though Australopithecus had an erect posture and a bipedal locomotion, the bipedal locomotion of Australopithecus is different from that of human beings in a number of ways. We call it a jog-trot type of locomotion. For human beings, there are two muscles which stabilize our pelvis during walk. One is the gluteus medius. Gluteus maximus and then gluteus minimus. These two muscles stabilize the pelvis region when we walk. As a result, we can walk comfortable. But for Australopithecus, these two muscles are totally absent. And in the pelvis, this bone is the ischium bone or ischial tuberosity. We call it as ischium. For quadrupedal animals, this bone used to be bit very long. But for human beings, this is a very small bone. But for Australopithecus, this bone still remains very long. As a result, they are not in a position to walk comfortable like human beings. They used to walk with a bent knee and bent hips in short, quick steps. They cannot walk continuously. They can make some fast 5 steps. They'll stand again. And once again, they will make some 5 steps with both bent knees and bent hip. This type of locomotion is physiologically inefficient, which consumes a lot of energy. So, let us now summarize the post-cephalic features or the post-cranial features of Australopithecus. Foramen magnum of Australopithecus is more centrally placed like the human beings. Then, there is a curve in the lumbar region of the vertebral column of Australopithecus which shows that they had a erect posture. Then the pelvis is bowl shaped. Along with that, there is a torsion angle in the femur bone. These are weight bearing modifications, and after that the knees are straight. Presence of linea aspera in the femur bone of the Australopithecus again provides evidence for this erect posture and bipedal locomotion. Linea aspera is a small groove found in the backside of the femur bone which provided attachment areas for the muscles in the thigh region. There are a number of weight bearing modifications in the ankle and in the feet. For example, the arching of the feet bones. These are weight bearing modifications, and all these modifications are found only in the hind limbs and not in the forearms. This suggests that Australopithecus had an erect posture and a bipedal locomotion. Though it had a bipedal locomotion, the bipedal locomotion of Australopithecus is different from that of human bipedalism in a number of ways. There are two muscles which stabilize our pelvis during walk, the gluteus medius and the gluteus minimus. These muscles are totally absent in Australopithecus. Along with this, the ischial tuberosity, that is the ischium bone, is a bit long for Australopithecus like the quadrupedal animals. As a result, Australopithecus couldn't walk comfortable like human beings. That locomotion is called as jog trot like walk, where Australopithecus walk by keeping its knees and hip in a bent position. So with this position, they can make only some 5 or 6 quick short steps, after which again it need to stand. And once again, it will make some 5 or 6 steps. So this jog trot like locomotion is not physiologically efficient. It needs a large output of energy for walking. Thank you.